Earth orbits a fairly ordinary star, one of roughly 300 billion stars in our cosmic home, the Milky Way galaxy. The Milky Way is one of roughly 100 billion galaxies in the observable universe. Astronomers believe that all massive galaxies have supermassive black holes at their centers. The Milky Way is no exception. And the black hole at the center of the Milky Way is thought to have a mass of 4 million solar masses. The observations that put us on a path to this understanding were made at Palomar with the Hale telescope. In 1963, Caltech astronomers Martin Schmidt, Jesse Greenstein, and Bev Oak were studying a new class of mysterious objects called quasars. Schmidt measured the first optical spectrum of a quasar known to us as 3C273, using the prime focus spectrograph on the Hale telescope. While there were prominent spectral features in the data, they occurred at unexpected wavelengths that did not correspond to known stellar spectral lines. Soon Schmidt realized the spectral features he had measured were common lines of hydrogen, oxygen, and magnesium, but were redshifted away from their rest wavelengths, indicating a recession speed of nearly 50,000 kilometers a second. This recession speed implied that the source was at great distance, billions of light years, and the source must be tremendously luminous, trillions of times more luminous than the Sun. Today we understand quasars like 3C273 as examples of so-called active galactic nuclei that release tremendous energies during the ingestion of matter by supermassive black holes at their centers. Roughly 5% of all galaxies exhibit AGN behavior. And in 1978, Caltech astronomers Wal Sargeant and Peter Young, using the Hale, found dynamical evidence of the very high masses driving these AGN, millions to billions of times the mass of the Sun. Their method measured the range of stellar speeds found in the centers of galaxies, so-called velocity dispersion. Applying the same method to normal galaxies like our own, they too showed evidence for massive objects at their centers. Essentially all massive galaxies have these central black holes, and a census of galaxy properties indicate that central mass is correlated with both velocity dispersion and brightness. Central black holes appear to be important in galaxy formation and evolution. The center of our galaxy is close enough that we can observe the orbits of individual stars, and the inferred orbits indicate that the central black hole has a mass of 4 million solar masses. While impressive, the Milky Way's central black hole is modest in size compared with some. For example, the black hole recently imaged in the core of the giant elliptical galaxy Messier 87 is thought to be roughly 1,000 times more massive, approximately 5 billion solar masses. It is clear that the pervasive presence of these black holes is not just an oddity, but an important part of structure formation in our universe.